Apple's worldwide developer conference happened this last week, and they had an announcement that in the next version of macOS, they're going to be supporting Linux containers. You'll be able to spin up a container with just a simple command. And obviously, I want to hear your thoughts on this, because to me, you're the container guy. What do you think? What do you think about Apple's announcement, and what does this mean for developers?
It was kind of a long time coming. I was pretty surprised that Apple didn't move into the WSL game before. Okay. Because like Windows has WSL too, which effectively runs a VM with some containers inside it, which makes it pretty easy to run Linux stuff on Windows. On macOS, we don't really have any of that up until now. Like you could run VMs manually, either through Apple's own framework or through something like Colima or through VMware Fusion, or those kind of options. So you could run a full-fledged VM, but there was no real OS integration with any of that, which to me always felt kind of weird when you consider that Apple themselves, they run Linux on their servers. Like all of the Apple server-side stuff is basically a bunch of Linux, Kubernetes, container stuff everywhere. So their own developer experience within the company must have been pretty crap for a little while now, especially because the servers they have don't run Apple Silicon, they run actual normal AMD and Intel chips. So if you want to do test builds, validation, testing, or anything on their own laptops, you're not on the right architecture anyways. You can run containers, and by their definition of containers, it's actually just OCI containers, so it's Docker-style container images. And they're not run as containers, they run as VMs. They effectively are doing the same thing as Kata does on Intel and AMD chips, where every single container is actually running a virtual machine. That's one approach we can do. We're actually looking at implementing something like that in Incus as an opt-in feature for those who have some kind of legal requirements or the policy requirements that you want absolutely everything isolated in their own VMs. The reason why for us we want to do it opt-in is because the performance is trash. I understand why they went that way, which was mostly like, hey, this is the safe approach, and most people, we really only want to run a couple of containers to then have a Linux environment they can work in. I've got a problem with calling that a container, because it's not. It's a virtual machine. It's purely marketing. People understand container. They want containers everywhere. The problem is that now they also misunderstand what it is, because they think this is a normal container, and it's not.